अस्सलाम वालेकुम। टुडे इज़ आवर लास्ट लेक्चर एंड दिस लेक्चर इज़ आवर लैब एंड टुडेज लैब इज़ अबाउट ऑसिलोस्कोप। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वांट टू टेल यू अबाउट दैट व्हाट एवर लैब आई हैव सेलेक्टेड फॉर यू इज हैव अ रीज़न बिहाइंड दैट एंड द रीज़न इज दैट even you are not the students for engineering or technical background, but you have to read these type of equipments because you will be working with technical companies or with the technical teams. So last time, the last lab we did was about the digital or analog multimeters. What was the reason of giving you that lab? The reason was that we studied about current, voltage and electromagnetic waves, flow of current. We studied all these things in the applied physics lecture. But what happened is that the theoretical knowledge is not enough. You should know that how this current, voltage, these are measured in actual life. So that when you will go in the industry and you will be working with some technical organization or technical team, so if they talk about those instruments or you have to do some type of management with them, you know or you have a knowledge for those. So in the last lab, we study about multimeters. What they were doing? Actually, multimeter, or you can say voltmeter or ammeter, anything, they are used to measure the current or voltage. You remember in last lab, when we connect our voltmeter or ammeter, you can say multimeter, with the current source or a voltage source, they give us some type of reading, 120 volt or 5 volt, anything. So the main task of that multimeter was to show us the main reading, the values. But today we are going to study about the oscilloscope. What is this oscilloscope? If we already know the reading from the multimeter, then why we need the oscilloscope? This is all the theory. What is oscilloscope? What are the types of oscilloscope? How this is used? But you can read from there. But why this is used, this I can tell you. So what is oscilloscope? For example, you have some electrical or electronics equipment with you. With the help of voltmeter or ammeter or multimeter, you will measure the actual current passing through it, actual voltage passing through it, or you can also check the connectivity, that if this wire is working correctly or it's broken, if the component is working or not, because whenever you will connect the voltmeter knobs with that, it will show you the reading. If it's not working, it will give you zero reading. If it's working, it will give you the exact reading. But if it's half working, then the reading will be low. But if you want to check that how the current is passing, now listen carefully, that ammeter was how much is passing, oscilloscope is how is passing. How is passing means, I give you an example. For example, if you have a tunnel, you know tunnels which are made on the mountains mostly, from where the motorways or the train can pass through it. Now, in the on the exit of that tunnel, there is one screen that is showing you how many cars are passing through it. How the cars are passing, at which speed passing, small cars or big trucks, they will not tell you. The screen will only tell you how many cars are passing. If you want to know that which type of cars are passing, you have to place something, cameras or equipment inside the tunnel. If you place that inside the tunnel, then you will know how the cars are passing. Are they passing one by one? Or are they overtaking with each other? Are they passing with high speed? Are they passing at very low speed? So for this information, you have to use other type of equipment or camera. So this is also the same in the case of oscilloscope and multimeter. Multimeter will only tell you how much passing, what is the value. But oscilloscope will tell you how passing, how the current is passing, how the current look like when it pass through this component or this circuit or this wire. So there are, they said that it has four types of systems. Let me turn on the pen so that, okay, it said that it has four types of system: imaging, triggering, horizontal and vertical. Why these four types of systems? As I told you, how the current is passing, so it will give you a vertical graph, it will give you an horizontal value, it can give you a triggered system value or a graph, it can give you images, it can plot the graphs if you give the data to it. So these are all functions of an oscilloscope. Types of oscilloscopes are same: digital, analog, USB or portable oscilloscope. I think it is common sense that digital, as same in multimeter, it will give you digital values, it will get the digital plots, all these things. Analog will give analog thing. USB oscilloscopes will be also, it's more advanced, and portable is most latest, you can say. So in digital, what they are using, there will be digital frequencies, analog circuit converters will be used. We no need to go deep inside that what is ADC. Actually ADC is analog to digital converter, because the current we are using in our homes, they are analog. So if you want to convert it in digital, it will be ADC, but inside analog it will be digital to analog converter. So these are the deep things which you no need to think about. You just read this theory, that what is digital oscilloscope, what is analog oscilloscope, what is USB oscilloscope and what is portable. So why they are used again? Because we want to see how our current is passing. So this means that they are 90% used in R&Ds and in production and in labs. Why? Because when we want to make something, we want to know the inside of that thing. For example, if you go to the bio labs, the most common equipment is what? That is microscope. Microscope should be there. Why? Because microscope can see deep inside the microorganisms, and that is compulsory for making something new. Same like that in electrical or technical field, if you want to make something new or research or development, then oscilloscope is the basic equipment you should have in the lab, because it can see deep inside the current, deep inside the voltage, from where you can make the changes, you can record the changes. So oscilloscopes are used in mostly R&Ds, production departments and in labs. It is used to determine how much noise is in the circuit. So what is noise? Noise, like for example, sometimes you are listening, watching television. Nowadays it happens very little, but if your telephone calls came to your mobile, it will interrupt your FM, AM or your TV channel. That is called noise. So how much noise inside your circuit? That is also can be seen from the oscilloscope. So here down, one by one, they showed you that first you have to open this type of